surround ourselves with people that winning means a lot to, and we're going to win.
This is the most important thing that I'm doing in my life right now, and I want to see the Tampa Bay Buccaneers back up there playing in the division playoff.
And I have the confidence in Coach Perkins to let me and this team to go ahead and be as good as we can possibly be.
But I'm very happy to be here, and I can assure you, we will win.
Good evening, and welcome to our look at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers as we enter the 90s. Tonight I'm joined by Dick Crippen in Detroit, Michigan, who is with the Buccaneers as they get ready to play the Detroit Lions tomorrow afternoon. Also joining me in the studio tonight is Tommy Korn, who tells us that it's been a very busy year over at One Buc Place.
Oh, no question about that, Chris. You know, after two consecutive 5-11 seasons, it became pretty apparent that personnel changes were in the offing. But no one could have predicted how far-reaching these changes would be.
Well, if we don't turn around next year, I'll be holding this press conference saying goodbye next year. You know, that's the way it is in this game.
That statement by Ray Perkins went far beyond face value. In effect, it was an alarming message, signifying that with the coming of a new decade, so too was a change in team and front office strategies. We were barely settled into 1990 when word came that veteran running back James Wilder was left unprotected. An unceremonious farewell to the team's most formidable rusher of the 1980s. For the new year spelled a new number, number 40. Tampa Bay successfully extricated Gary Anderson from an unpleasant situation in San Diego.
I'm just glad it's behind me, to tell you the truth. You know, it's been a long road, and it finally came to an end. So I'm glad to be here. It's where I wanted to be, at home, and back in Tampa, you know, where I belong. So I'm looking forward to playing for the Buccaneers.
Within 48 hours of the Anderson deal, Ray Perkins rolled the dice and went after two of the most scrutinized yet talented names in the NFL draft. Round one, Alabama linebacker Keith McCants got the call, despite rampant rumors of a questionably fit right knee.
And it affected me as well as my family. And they took it, my family took it real, real bad. And it worked on them mentally. I got over it, and I'm just looking forward to getting out there. I don't feel I have anything to prove, but I'm gonna do it anyway.
And then in round two, Perkins selected Tennessee running back Reggie Cobb, a sure first rounder until his episodes as a three-time drug offender.
Reggie Cobb sold me on the fact that that Reggie Cobb's gonna do what it takes, you know, to straighten his life out. You know, the thing he told me there in Houston, the most impressive thing that he said to me, he says, Coach, he said, I know you're real football all the way. He said, and it's, I've seen you across the sideline when I was in Tennessee. I remember seeing you when you were in New York. He said, I just want you to understand something. Football is not the most important thing to me. He said, straightening Reggie Cobb's life out is the most important thing to me. Now that impressed me.
The addition of Anderson, a healthy Keith McCants, and a reformed Reggie Cobb alone fueled optimism to new heights. Caught in the whirlwind of enthusiasm was owner Hugh Culverhouse. He publicly crescendoed the team's bright outlook, projecting an 11-5 season and a spot in the postseason playoffs. Still, there was another piece of this personnel puzzle missing that Perkins felt to be essential, a piece that Tampa Bay was willing to give up their 1992 first-round pick for, Colts quarterback Chris Chandler. An insurance policy to back up starter Vinny Testaverde.
I'm here this year to try to learn the system and improve and get better and mainly help him win football games. You know, that's the most important thing this year as far as I'm concerned.
The puzzle has now become clear. A visual statement. The Buccaneers' hope makes them a contender, not a pretender. And then came the most intense maneuvering over the Labor Day weekend. Head coach Ray Perkins traded cornerback Rod Jones to Cincinnati for defensive end Jim Scow. And then one day later, waived kicker Donald Igwebuike, running back Lars Tate, and punter Chris Moore.
I like our football team, and I'm going to say so. I need to say so. Nobody else is. Why shouldn't I? I like our football team. I like our guys on our team. And I just hope we can stay healthy, because I know we're going to get better as time goes along, and we're going to win.
And let's not forget the coaching changes on defense, the package plan of Fred Bruni and Tommy Brazier from the Atlanta Falcons. They have implemented the attack zone defense, a defense that will be thoroughly challenged from the get-go tomorrow. Now let's go out to Detroit, where Dick Crippen is standing by with Bucs owner Hugh Culverhouse. Dick?
That's right, and certainly he is the man that has to look at this team from the top down and say, what do we have here? What do you have going into this 90 series?
I think we have the young squad that has such enthusiasm and a beautiful attitude. They want to get to play it. They can't wait for the game to start. And they feel very confident in themselves and in themselves as a team.
They don't only feel confident, you feel confident. You know, your prediction got an awful lot of conversation around town.
Well, I certainly am going to be happy to tell everyone I told you so.
But you feel very good about it. I know Coach Perkins says this is the best feeling he's had with any team going into a preseason. You feel the same way?
Yes, I do. I'll tell you why. While we have 18 new faces, we have 18 better players than what we had last year. We had a good enthusiasm last year, but we did not have the depth. When we lost our entire running game last year, it was disaster. Vinny Testaverde didn't get a fair shot because we had to pass. So the other team pinned back the ears and went after Vinny.
Okay, well, we're going to see what happens. Tomorrow is going to be a big game.
Well, if we win by 1 point, I'll be happy, but 10 would be great.
Okay, and we'll remember that prediction, too. I think that's one everybody will agree with. And, of course, Mr. Culverhouse referred to the running game. That's part of the offense. We're going to line up the offense when we come back, and we're going to take a look at Gary Anderson.
They're a young and much improved football team. Vinny Testaverde is coming into his own, and you know, I think they have some great offensive talent, and with the addition of McCants, and if we can get Thomas healthy, I'm sure they'll have two very formidable outside pass rushers. So, you know, it's a team obviously on the upswing.